This obesity is becoming an epidemic across the U.S. And John Dapkevich is live in studio with one author who has a tough love message for folks trying to lose weight. John, I don't know if I'm ready to hear this because I've been working on this for like 3 years now.
Yeah, I think a lot of people probably feel like that, Monica. The book is called Die Fat or Get Tough, 101 Differences in Thinking Between Fat People and Fit People. It was written by Steve Siebold, a former professional tennis player who one day found himself 40 pounds overweight and then did something about it. He joins us in studio this morning to talk about it. Good morning. Thanks for being with us.
Hey, thanks, John.
So the premise for the book is interesting. It's essentially saying if you're overweight, you don't have a medical problem, it's your fault. I could see that also being controversial. What has the response been when you talk about this in various places?
Well, when I went on the Today Show, I had 3 death threats. They had to give
really?
Me
oh,
they had to give me security at the BBC in London. Mm-hmm. And all I'm saying is, if we get fat, it's our fault. We're responsible. We need to take responsibility. It's not the government. It's not the size of the sodas we drink. It's not our portions. It's us that's our own destroyer, and we need to fix it.
So what is, then, the main difference in the thinking between fit people and people who are overweight?
There are a lot of them, but the main one probably is that we found that in the study, we interviewed 500 fat people, 500 fit people, went to lunch, you know, dinner, breakfast with
what
them.
What determined a fat person?
Well, anyone that was, you know, whether it was obese or, you know, at least 50 pounds overweight. We had a lot of people
okay.
who were 100 pounds
More
overweight.
Than.
Yeah, exactly. 50 pounds was sort of the lowest one.
Okay.
Right. And they and the fit people eat for health. They've got the salmon with the sauce on the side and the salad. And, you know, people like me are going in there and saying, I'll take the pizza. Give me some nachos on top of it. You know, it's easy to do, but that we found that they think completely differently in a lot of ways.
Is it, though, I mean, are you saying that there's no difference in metabolism? Some person could just have a faster metabolism than someone else that allows them to eat more or worse stuff than someone else.
No question. I mean, some people are genetically gifted. You're from LA. Some of the models out there, right? I mean, they're genetically gifted. And there are other people who are on the other side of the equation. But at the end of the day, for 99% of us, there's 1% of people who have some kind of eating disorder or psychological disorder. The rest of us, it's us. Now, some people it's tougher, you know, for than others. But at the end of the day, we're responsible. It's not anyone else.
So there was an interesting concept in the book that you say that if you're successful on a diet, or if you stick to a diet 99% of the time and cheat only 1%, that's considered a failure. That seems a bit harsh.
Well, it is, but it's a slippery slope. How many of us have said, oh, I'm going to start over on Monday. I'll just start over on Monday. I mean, what if you came home and told your spouse, hey, honey, guess what? I was 99% faithful this year, which is up from 65% last year. This is fantastic.
But isn't having
You're
a donut...
You're going to die. She's going to kill you.
But isn't having a donut different than having an affair with your secretary?
Well, it is logically, but psychologically it's not, because it's a slippery slope. I have the donut, then I say, well, I'm kind of off it already. I might as well start over on Monday. I'm just going to have a little, maybe all the nachos now. Well, I already blew it now, so I might as well just start over next week. And we keep starting over, and Monday never comes.
Mm-hmm. So question then, when's the last time you had a cheeseburger or something like that?
I'm pretty sure it was yesterday. Yeah, because now I can afford to do that sometimes. Not very often, but I can afford to do it. I did have a good cheeseburger here in Vegas, good food here, and I loved it. But you got to really watch it, you know?
Again, the book is called Die Fat or Get Tough. It's a very interesting read. Available in stores now, right?
Right. Amazon.com.
Amazon.com as well. Steve, thank you very much.
Thank you.